And welcome to Something Else with Arya and Not KJ, episode number 027. Today, I'm scheduled, I'm planning on talking about Mid-South Wrestling episode from March 11th, 1982. But to be honest, right now, I want to talk about something that just really sucks right now. I started this show with KJ, we talked about how we wouldn't just talk about wrestling. We would talk about LGBT issues as they came up. And obviously, the show became more about wrestling than it did anything LGBT related. And it wasn't for a desire to avoid talking about it. I think sometimes we didn't want to dampen any of the fun that this show was supposed to be. But to be honest, at this point, shit needs to be said and shit needs to be talked about. And to be honest, when I pieced together this week's show and I watched the episode of Mid-South, I watched it yesterday, took all my notes, made all my notes of audio that I wanted to play. I pulled up some wacky news to talk about. At no point was I going to discuss what I'm going to kick off the show by talking about. And now I'm recording this show, and it doesn't matter when you're actually going to hear this, but I'm recording the show on Tuesday, the 14th, Valentine's Day. And as a lot of you may be aware, there was a 16-year-old transgender teenage girl in the UK that got murdered over the weekend, named Brianna Ghey. And let's face facts, she was murdered by two, allegedly murdered by two 15-year-olds. And this part isn't alleged because of who she was and who she became. And this is yet another just disgusting, needless tragedy. One more transgender person has been murdered, and it's not going to stop. And the ridiculous thing about this is the BBC re was reporting this morning that the police were investigating over whether or not it was a hate crime. You know, this girl was targeted because she was trans. She wasn't targeted, like, you know, just because these two alleged murderers were just really fucking bored that day and decided that the next person to walk by them was gonna get killed. That's not what the fuck happened. And the fact is, sorry. Fact is, stuff like this happens all the time. And it's going to be a big deal for about a week, if that. Like, it's a big deal right now to the transgender community. No one else seems to even know about it, which is just, you know, the worst freaking part. And even then, in a couple days, this is all going to be forgotten. We'll all move on, much like All those school shootings we kept having, and it's not like that's ever stopped. But what happens? It's the same fucking pattern. People get murdered. We talk about it for a week, if that, then we all move on with our lives until the next one. And here's a fact. I am 38 years old. I knew when I was 11 years old that I was who I am. I didn't know how to label it. I didn't know what to do about it. But I knew that I am who I am. I knew that I was Arya, for better or worse. This is me. And it took me until I was 31 years old, 20 years later, to get the courage to come out and be myself. And despite having a ton of support from everybody in my life, the fact is that every day when I leave my apartment, whether I'm going to work, whether I'm going to the grocery store, whether I'm going to the gym, no matter what I'm doing, I am keenly aware of everybody and everything around me. I'm very aware of every man, woman, child on my block that I walk by in the store, that I see at the mall. And I'm just on a high alert that at some point, some nut job who hates me for deciding to be happy, deciding to live my life the way that I should have been all along, some nut job's going to decide that that's not good enough, that because I'm not living up to the standards that they believe that I should have, I need to be killed, I need to be assaulted, I need to be attacked, and God knows what else. And there are, and who knows if anyone's going to listen to this at this point. Not that it really fucking matters, but there are assholes out there who are using this shit as further proof. There are actually assholes out there saying that if Brianna, if this 16-year-old girl, if she wouldn't have transitioned, then she wouldn't have been murdered. And this is another reason why we shouldn't let children transition. What the fuck is wrong with some of you people? You know what would have happened if she didn't transition? She'd have been fucking depressed as a teen. She would have sat and spent years and years wondering what's wrong with her. Why can't she be like everybody fucking else? And you know how I know that's what she would think? Because it's what I fucking thought for years. And it's what I bet a whole lot of trans people before they came out had the same fucking thought. And you would much rather, let's be honest, you fucking assholes out there would much rather us be dead than be alive and happy. Because, how dare anybody be happy? And while I'm at it, and I'm gonna fucking call out the rest of the LGBTQ plus community. And this always surprises, my straight friends when I point this out. There is no community that's more divisive, that is at each other's throats more than the LGBT community. And right now, and it's not everybody, obviously, and I don't want to get into this. It's not fucking everybody. But do you know how many fucking people in the LGBT community are against trans people? And the fucking fact is, every letter of the LGBT community, they all have enough people within them that have hatred towards the other letters. I have friends who are shocked to know that there are lesbian women out there who specifically hate trans people. And there are gays who hate lesbians, and they all hate bisexuals, and now they all hate transgender people. And I bet asexuals are in there somewhere. And every fucking person, because instead of us uniting as fucking one and standing up together against all this fucking bullshit that we're up against, they decided, let's also, turn our back on trans people. But guess what? Guess what, LGBT people? You know who they're gonna turn after us? They're gonna go after the gays. They're gonna go after the lesbians. They're gonna go after the bisexuals. Because they're like, oh, we can't have drag queens around children. It's overly sexual. Well, next will be we can't have gay people around children because, all LGBT people are pedophiles and they're gonna go after children. And that shit's gonna be next. And if you're sitting out there and you think that, you're somehow special and it's not gonna happen to you next, guess what? It fucking is. So it's about fucking time that you all get off your asses. You put aside the bullshit little bickering they all have for each other, and we stand united as one. Because honestly, I am tired of being afraid to die for just being me. I live in the most liberal state in the country. Perhaps the most transgender friendly state in the country. And if you think for one second that I don't think I'm going to get murdered at some point because I'm trans, you have another fucking thing coming. And this whole thing is just ridiculous. Let us live. What exactly is any of y'all's fucking problem with trans people? Why? Because why? Because the pretend man in the sky, created a fake book that said that it was wrong. I'm sorry, I went to catechism classes. I went to church when I was a kid. I've read more of the Bible than most of y'all. And the fact is, there's no fucking point in that Bible that is against trans people. And if you want to point out, oh, well, they're against gay people because of Leviticus, go through that fucking book and write down everything that they admonish. And at the end of the day, no matter if you want to believe in God, that's your right. But at the end of the day, you know what it said in the fucking Bible? God said to love everybody. At no point in the Bible does it say God said to love the straight cisgender people. It said to love everybody. So don't pick and choose what parts of your Bible you want to fucking listen to and adhere to.